Okay, so habang inaayos ko yung PowerPoint, yung survey po na isinagawa ng Iloilo College Council, all in all po dito po sa Diliman ay may 19 student councils. So lahat po ng mga konseho dito sa Diliman ay nakikabugnayan sa lahat ng kanilang mga constituents. At ang pinaka-aim naman po talaga ay magkaroon po ng representative per college. Isinagawa po ang survey itong August 27 to August 30. At sa kabuuan ay nakakuha po kami ng 1,678 respondents. So again, nilinawin lang din po namin na hindi po ito ang tindig ng buong UP Diliman. Ito po ang tindig ng Diliman respondents na nakuha po namin dito sa survey. Okay, Great Apart Survey Project. Okay, so this survey, again, by BLPP, the target population are bona fide students of the undergraduate and graduate students of UP Diliman for the first semester. And the sampling method used was convenient sampling and was done through site survey on the respective schools and colleges. So again, the date was from August 27 to the 30th. The objectives are the following: to gauge the knowledge of the respondents on the ELAP, the Priority Development Assistance Fund, to see if the respondent is aware of the projects of his or her district representative, for the respondent to determine the value of the projects of their district representative. Next, to see if the respondent is aware of the projects of the senators that they may have been funded by PILAC, to determine the stand of the respondent to the issue of the fourth barrel, to gauge the perception of the effectiveness of the respondent's part, to see if the respondent is aware of the projects of the senators that may have been funded by the PILAC, and to see if there is a possible bias for the respondents as a result of gaining from the PDAC. So then again, the Great Apart Survey is our tool to gauge the knowledge of our respondents. So here's the result. Out of the 1,678 respondents, 787 or 47% were for the abolition of PDAC, while 700 or 42% want to reform the PDAC. The 168 or the 10% of the respondents are still undecided, while 23 believe that the PDAC should be maintained. So, we have the descriptives here for college, pero sa akin naman po, ito pa lang po yung pinamahalaga ngayon. Ilalabas po namin sa media ang descriptives kasi makaba comprehensive po yung naging survey. There were about 20 to 25 questions para po malaman po natin yung kalaliman po ng kaalaman ng mga sudati tungkol po sa PDAC. So ito na po yung resulta na lumabas. Again, we are using this tool to gauge the knowledge of the students. Pero sa ulit-uli po, ang Iloilo College Council, ang tindig po dito ng 90 student council sa pinagsakan po namin kahapon, we are for the abolition of PDAC. Second, we are for the rechanneling of PDAC to education and basic social services. Number three, we are for the passage of the people's freedom of information. And number four, okay, so we contextualize, okay, the issue here in the University of the Philippines, since we wanted to rechannel the PDAC to the education sector. Of course, year one, it opposing the 1.43 budget cut here in UP, and of course, considering the 78 state universities and colleges that will be experiencing a budget cut in the fiscal year 2014. So that again, for the media and our friends, the descriptive and the analysis of the of our survey will be released tomorrow. So thank you.
Maraming salamat at pagsimulan mo pala yun. Okay, naasahan namin bukas, lalabas na yung results. So, ito yung mukhang interesting yung proportion. So ating forum, i-explain ni Juned Sunido kung anong mechanics sa forum. I-bigay ko na sa kanya yung floor.
Simple lang yung mechanics, no? Pag may tanong sa'yo, hold it sa microphone, introduce yourself, tapos ask you questions. Ito tayo natin, siguro, okay. Pag-inpokilin sa sakali, direkso na sa tanong. Okay? Sige. Okay. microphone.
Magandang hapon po, Professor Briones. Professor Manfred, yung tanong ko po ay para kay Professor Briones. Professor, paki-explain mo yung sabi ng Special Education Fund. Yung po ba ay para sa special education people with special needs? Ano po yung special education yun?
Yung special education fund ay isang hindi ko maalala yung exact percentage, siguro 3% to 5%. Tayo lahat magbubayad ng real property tax, yung nasa may lupa. Ang nagpo-collect yan, generally, ang probinsya at ang mga munisipyo. Now, percentage, grooming at sinukuha. Kailangan itong bantayan kasi itong special education fund kung minsan inaabuso. Kung limaw, may mga visiting fireman, famous personalities darating, gagamitin yung special education fund. Kung saan-saan niya napupunta. Kaya kailangan niyang babantayan at in-audit talaga yan. At sa kung makikita rin ng auditor na hindi ginagamit sa for education, na ano nila yan, yung report. Problema naman, pagka-report, malaman ka na po. Yun. Alam na po, special children.
Maraming salamat po kasi po, ang website ko po ay Special Education Philippines. Alam ko po na ayaw rin yung salitang special. Pero, ang dami po kasi nangangailangan ng mga magulang ng assessment. At kung meron pa ng Special Education Fund, bakit kaya hindi namin narinig na available pa rin?
Lahat na municipality, lahat na probinsya, ay Special Education Fund. Tapos, at the level of the local government, the planning, sila nag-umpisa niya, it's very detailed all the way down the line. So, mayroong education committee. Sila ang nagpo-propose na kung ano ang ipabudget na manggagaling sa Special Education Fund. Usually, the education committee includes civil society. Yung mga civil society ang good standing. Madali yung mga mahalata kasi sa mga municipal doon sa provincial kita-kita. So, palagay ko pa rin ninyong tingnan yung utilization ng Special Education Fund. Limbawa sa Quezon City, okay pa nga. Halimbawa sa Makati, halimbawa sa Manila, paano nila ginagamit yung Special Education Fund? Very clear kung paano yan, for what, anong pasyento.
Last question naman po, Professor Briones. So, kung magulang ako, wala akong access doon. Kailangan lumapit ako sa isang sa government or sa isang society or ganyan po ba?
Palagay ko, let na rin mo akong Quezon City, Makati. You can like easily go, start with the office of the mayor. And there are many information systems in life. By the way, ako I rely very heavily on the EILG monitoring system, yung FPFINS nila, Financial Information Monitoring Service. Kasi quarterly yan, ang audit is annually. Doon pinapasok yung budget, doon mo makikita. Doon mo makikita yung expected revenue, transparent revenue, expenditure, utang, at saka yung ranking. Halimbawa, but also, ang ranking ng performance ng local government unit, hindi Makati, hindi Manila, hindi Quezon City, hindi Valenzuela. Palaging nagpo-compete ang Valenzuela at San Juan for highly urbanized, taking into consideration everything na from utilization, collection, trends, dependency on IRA. Ang daming data, doon mo makukuha ang Special Education Fund amount. The reward, that is the legacy of Jesse Robredo. Jesse Robredo required all local government units to post at least 18 financial reports on their website or on bulletin boards if they don't have a website. So this should be available. For me, nakikita ko very accessible yung website on the island,
BNMR. Thank you.
Thank you.
Korea and it's really halfway by the way. But ito, two questions. The BEM is implementing the performance information budget. And they said that it would like reduce political patronage because it would be for their budget to be approved, kailangan naka may metrics supposedly that they have to meet and then But then I asked BBM if the president special purpose fund or any of those items included in the PIB said no. So is there any way that we can like monitor the performance and then what mechanism can we have for it to be can be tracked? Number two question, is the LGU code isa sa mga probably problems in the constraints for national government or implementing agencies to have the power to like have this fund and then identify that this LGUs have the problem instead of these LGUs going to the congressmen and ask for this project. Kasi because of the LGU code some subject to abuses like ultimo MOO in ako korako.
Paano ma-access ang audit report sa President
Sobia? With the EID system that they're implementing.
Wala doon, kasi it's based on request. And this is why, I'm not saying corrupt siya, I'm saying it's very vulnerable. We know historically that it has been abused. Kasi parang ang congressman din, nabibigay din natin po lahan, nabibigay din ang kanal, mga libro, mga gamot, nabibigay din ang cheque. It is audited, but you have to access the audit report. Saka makikita mo yan yung biases. I have seen one audit report of the President's social fund. It just so happened that one of my students nandun sa work din na niya. So nakuha ko yun. But right now, in this base of open information, dapat nasa website siya ng COA. Kasi hindi lang dapat ilalagay sa website ng COA, ayaw intelligence fund na ubod-ubod na magkalagay-lagay. There is President Social Fund. I know that is an audit report. Nga lang, sino makakakita ng audit report? Ang tanong mo dyan, not so much corrupt as corruption, as paano yung basis ng pag-allocate ng pera na yan? Is it on a need basis? Is it on a request basis? Is it on an occasion basis? Is it seasonal, panahon ng election? Hindi mo malalaman because the public has no access. So I believe it should be made accessible because there is an audit report. I know that it's an audit report. And besides, pag po report, kung magkano, have you noticed during election time, pag po always comes out with this big TV advertisement. Sila ang number 3 revenue earner ng government. Ito yung mga contributions nila. So, ganun kalaki. 10 billion ang schedule nilang contributions this year, or 2014. No? So, makita, palagay ko, dapat anuin natin yan. It's the allocation system which probably might be very sensitive, especially for us. Yung ano naman, yung sinasabi mo naman na paano yung mga projects, etc. Ang sinasabi ko, mas malaking ingay magagawa mo sa local level unless dynasty, no? Dynasty, mahirap talaga kasi office your head is agad. Especially in certain provinces, pati auditory ng boss, diba? Alam naman nyo yan. Pero generally, mas madali kang mag-access kasi maski hindi mo ma-access yung record, makikita mo yung project, makikita mo yung kalsada, makikita mo yung iskulahan, makikita mo yung quality, no? ng proyekto. Kasi may mga local radio, may mga community radio, magugulat kayo, ang daming registration. In Dumaguete, for example, yung pag-discuss ng budget ng Dumaguete City, it is aid. Nadisinig sa radio yan. po yung mga labandela, naglalabay, yung mga driver ng jeep, nadinig nila ng pinag-usapan nila. So marinig nila na po, namingi lang pala ng bagong kusina o bagong kusina, etc. So makikriticize nila kasi narinig nila yung debate. At since you are in MASCOM, I think you should insist on that. At the local level, even at the local level, debate on money, on budget should be made accessible to the public. And that's very easy with registration.
Please go to the
next
one. Magandang tanghali po. Ako po si Ian Pilarte. Isa po sa mga kumakatawa ng core group ng EDSA tayo. Since ito ay ang sinasagawa po namin pagtitipon sa EDSA tayo ay isang interfaith prayer vigil.
September
11 po na gagawin po lamang sa EDSA Shrine. Ngunit sa labas po ng EDSA Shrine ay magkakaroon po ng isang interfaith prayer vigil. May tanong po, ang tanong po sana ay kung kami po ay magdarasal. Ano po yung dapat ipagdasal namin? Sino? At ano ang dapat isikilos ng Panginoon para ma-resolve lahat ito? Dahil po, gusto natin tanggalin mo ng anong klase man na court battle o ano mang special fund, di po ba? Pero mismo ang marasan niya ay sinasabi, hindi naman court battle ang aming pondo. So, ano po yung specific po na dapat na dinadasal mo namin? Kung kayo po ang tatanggihan namin.
Kung po ako magdadasal, dadasal ko na itong mga tao ito ay i-abolish yung court namin. Hindi lang yung pila. Nakita niya? Pila has already been abolished. Already said that for the 2014 there will be no Pinas. But that does not mean that there is no fourth balance. And yet, everybody says we are against Pinas. No, you cannot be against Pinas. You must be against the fourth balance. That to me, that's why when I heard the University Student Council, we want to abolish the Pinas. It's already been abolished. Too late. I mean, you know, you're, what you want to do is abolish the fourth balance, number one. So I will pray for the abolition of the fourth balance. And number two, I will pray that our people are going to find out the names of all these people, all these legislators who are involved in the fourth balance and make sure that they do not vote for them. Because prayer and action must go together. We must act, and that the song must be, what must be translated into action. We will not vote for any of the legislators' summons whose name appears in any irregularity, because that is only the tip of the iceberg. what has been audited is only a very small fraction of what has been used. Okay? I'm not seeing the lack.
Kami sa Silliman University, I chair Silliman University Board. We are having a parallel action also on September 11. And as far as I know, Jesus is Lord Fellowship, and Brother Edwin is joining in September 11 in announcement in Zion. I'm very sure many of the evangelical churches are going to join this interfaith action. Kasi kaya naman natin, isa lang naman yung Diyos natin. Maalala ko yung sinasabi sa Diyos na lang, ano yung paborito natin ng panahon ng mga it might be called a reason to our Lord. And I will bless them, di ba? So what does the Lord expect of you but to do justice, to walk humbly with your God, and this, nandiyan na yung lahat, whatever your denomination is. Kung ako naman ang pagdadasal, ang dinadasal ko, na sana maabutan ko yung total abolition of all lump sum appropriation, yung tinatawag natin for, no? Kasi napakarami. Yung ating body politics, ang dami ng lab, ang dami ng bukol. Oo. Parang ng cancer, no? kasi makikita nila sa listahan. So, yun ang pinagdadasal ko na hindi 20 years from now, hindi 15 years from now, pero umpisahan lang. Para kailangan umpisahan. Sana masusustain natin yan hanggang at the very least 2016. Kasi ugali natin, mata pa ako, nakikita ko ngayon sa mga cartoons ng Christmas, tinitira na talaga yung pork barrel. Every year, nagagalit tayo tungkol sa pork barrel. Every year, basta pag-usapan yung budget, lalabas yung pork barrel. Pero after the election, punta na yung mga kongresista, senador, they go to Europe, they go to Geneva, mag-shopping sila, panoorin nila si Manny Pacquiao, tapos na yung trabaho nila. Nakakalimutan naman nila, tapos nagagalit na naman tayo ulit pag-budget season na. Kaya, in a sense, itong ano, sinasabi ko, serendipitous itong Macaulay's team. Kasi talagang makita natin kung gaano ang tentacles ito. And even Macaulay's is very, very small. We're talking 10 billion in 10 years. We're talking 25 billion in 1 year. We're talking 310 billion in 1 year. No? So, sana masusustain at maabutan ang lahat. Hindi lamang sa mga estudyante akong ako. I remember one of my students, Ma'am, kung ako ang makukusun na, mag-senador na ako, hanggang I will fight for the father. Eh ngayon na, at hanggang 2016, yun ang masal ko.
Ganyan nga po, kasi sana na yung mundo na dito sa ating IAS Sport and sa different international studies. I just have an invitation and a clarifying question. Invitation to our two distinguished professors to be part of the UP faculty again for and this large broad national alliance for which is called the abolition of the fourth barrel system. I'll give you some of the statements later. Just a clarificatory question. On the presidential board, kasi sa media, when they talk about CDAP or foreign barrel, parang yung Congress people lang yung pinag-uusapan. And of course, mahalaga yun, no? But as I was listening to your both of your presentations, thank you so much. It's been so edifying. You mentioned CDAP as the foreign barrel, but of course, you also talk about, or you also say that there is a larger fourth barrel system beyond the VDAP. I don't know if I'm actually right in interpreting this. But and is that larger VDAP the same as the presidential fourth barrel? And if we say presidential fourth barrel, technically is that the special purpose fund? And how would you characterize, what is your take on the presidential fourth barrel?
Well, you know, my definition is very clear. The definition has to do with legislative work. That's what the fourth barrel is. What the legislators have said is, you know, why are you only looking at our fourth? Why don't you look at your fourth? Because, well, you know, the president is an executive. He's the one implementing. There is a very big difference between somebody who should be implementing and somebody who should be legislating. And there is no reason why legislators should be part and parcel of the executive function of choosing the court. Does that mean I'm for presidential court? No. Like we name, I hope she is, I hope I understood her. If there are lump sum funds, they must be accounted for and audited properly. I don't mind for the president to have a 10 billion calamity fund as long as we know what happened to it. That's it. If there's a special purpose, that's what the executive must have the flexibility to react to any situation, which is not within the authority or within the boundaries of the legislative. I do not want this confusion of the legislative court with what they call the executive court. I really don't. I think that they are two separate elements, and you know, just not just because it's lump sum doesn't mean it's court. Because, for example, the VDAP is going to be abolished. The lump sum VDAP is going to be abolished. But they're going to put in line items. The American port barrel system is on line items. Just because it's line items, it's no longer port, it's no longer lump sum. No, we have to think about what we're talking about here. We do not like this dispersion. I want to bring it up into the main environment of the day. We don't want to bring this dispersion, this divide by N mentality. Right? The presidential point is not divided by N. And all I need from the president is that if the auditor, I do not agree that the special audit, the audit should be for your eyes only. That's why I want the freedom of information there. But other than that, if the president wants 20 billion or 310 billion, let's find out whether it is appropriate or not by the auditor. But I don't want to say, let's take it away from him. What's the matter? He's the executive. That's what he's there for God's sake. Let's not get carried away here, please. Thank you.
I agree with the distinction. And when I am interviewed, although I'm always quoted and talk about presidential work, that is not accurate, because I always make the distinction. Because historically, by definition, sport is always identified with what is given to the legislators for local purposes. Again, and the one of my Canadian concept on that, which we got from the American. But the reason why we are interested also in the special purpose fund is because one wants to find a legal basis for it. Because there is no such word in the Constitution. Secondly, you have to think in terms of proportion, because this present president is not going to be our president forever. There was a time when special purposes fund accounted for over 60% of the total expenditure program of government. Lahat na ayaw nila, pati agricultural enhancement fund, nandoon. And then, each time, we have been campaigning against it since 2006, maglilipat sila. A very successful reduction of special purpose fund. This is very recent, and probably we are all aware of it. But in the 2013 budget, because we campaigned that part of it should go to the Department of Health, 12 billion pesos. Alam, natingilan sila sa inay namin, tapos we supported with some congressmen, nalipat 12 billion pesos to the Department of Health for health facilities, but alam natin kulang more. So when we ask for accountability, we know where to go. Ang problem kasi sa special purpose fund is because it is one line. And the temptation to vulnerability, I always use the word vulnerability, it's very, it's almost irresistible depending on the personality of the executive. And the people around him, I know for a fact, I don't know if you have experience mo yan. When you have an agency, siyempre firma ka ng firma, hindi mo na matrack how much you already have signed, etc. from this particular fund. So I made it a practice that always when I'm asked to sign a check, lalo na kung malaki, ilagay doon kung magkano ng balance, magkano na lahat na firman ko, magkano na lang balance sa particular fund, para you have an idea. Because if every day you are signing sa hundreds and thousands, dahil ang laki na hinahawakan ng pondo eh. So, kailangan, this is why sabi namin, that education fund, it is building fund, it is balikyan kay Louis Strong. Mayroon doon on internet, etc. Given to the agencies which are promoting internet education, whatever. Calamity education, nandiyan sa batas yan. Sino dapat ang frontline agencies? Para naman, maklaro at people like this lady who was acting kanina, alam nila kung sinong pupuntahan nila, alam nila si Leo pupuntahan nila. Ngayon, even the traffic, the president is named, di ba? Let's make a statement on the traffic. When you have the Metro Manila Development Authority, which is mandated by law to take care of traffic. So that's what we want, no?
Excuse me, let me just add something here. We're talking about abolishing the third family. And there is a companion effort. We want to reform the budgeting system because it is ridiculous that you have off-budget items of such large amounts, the Malampaya Fund, the Motor Vehicle Fund, etc., etc. That is a different thing altogether from the fourth barrel, and I do not want to dissipate. Let's get one thing done at a time, right? the Malampaya Fund, the Motor Vehicle User Charges Fund, that's tinatawag mo, of budget. Tapos, you know, then you're talking about the Special Purpose Fund, where, you know, even assuming that there is a legal basis for that Special Purpose Fund, the fact is that it should be audited every year, and we should be able to find out what has happened to that. That's all we want. Because the basis for removing the court, the legislative court balance, is economic, it is rational, it is developmental in nature. The other one is because we don't know what's going on. Here in the court balance, we know exactly what's going on. We know exactly it's being used and it's being diverted into private pockets. So please, can we be a little bit more strategic in our efforts?
Okay, we have room for two or three more questions. Please approach the mic.
Ma'am, Linda Taneda, ABS-CBN. Ma'am, first of all, what are your proposals? Sinabi na kasi natatanggalin sa budget yung PIDA. So, saan mo ilalagay? Kasi yung Congress ngayon, may sarili silang bala.
Hindi na lagay mo sa line 8, yung frontline agency. Bibigay mo sa mga probinsya. Sila ang may alam kung ano ang nangyayari. At saka, the province is going to be, you know, is going to be more coherent and more integrative in it. Right now, the provinces have the least of the IRA, or in terms of what they bear of the local government expenditures and what they get as a share. Talagang they get less as a share than what is costing them. Samantalang yung mga cities, ang laki-laki na nakukuha nila, ang liit-liit na kanilang share of the burden. So that's part of the budget, you know, looking at the overall budget. And we should do that. And I totally back up. We in saying, we've got to get all these things back into the budget. No such thing as an off budget. Off budget, laki-laki, for heaven's sake. And then of the special funds. So, what do we do? Remove the 25 billion? Give it. How much of that port value was supposed to be for scholarships? Give it to the scholarship fund. The government is a scholarship fund that is maintained by that can be accessed by all the Department of Education all the way down to wherever, the municipal level. They just don't have it now. Why? Because the congressman wants to say, ako ang nagbigay. The hell? It's not siya ang nagbigay, ang taong bayan ang nagbigay. Bakit binibigay natin sa anak ng it is so easy.
As of last night, even though it will be part of the line budget, they still want to have a say. Meaning the congressman want to be the one to choose.
They keep on saying, wow, if, you know, you remove the kid after much, you might as well abolish Congress. Well, that's a good idea. that's beside the point. Because they're saying Congress has the power over the purse. That's true, but it is a policy power, not a parochial kakalkanin mo. In other words, Congress is there to decide how much should be spent, to whom it should go, etc. But not who do I give the scholarship fund to, and you know, what fund do I get going. That's not, that is a confusion, a deliberate, I think, because these people are not dumb. There is a deliberate confusion in their mind as to what the power of the purse means. The power of the purse is allocation, stability, etc., etc. I don't have the power of the
line. So now who will decide where will it go? Like you're saying, line budget, but still who will break it down?
Well, speaking, I'll tell you, there are local development councils, there's the Paranagari Development Council, there's the Municipal Development Council, there's the Provincial Development Council, they all have development plans for their particular areas. Not only do they have plans, they have public investment programs where they are listing the projects that they need so badly. Which the congressman, unless he's part of the dynasty, ignores. So there is a parallel system going on, which is very bad. You know, even if the congressman were choosing his projects, this bit of dividing by Congress 70 million to each is not developmental. It serves no developmental purpose.
My last question is just to clarify. Hindi yung hindi na kailangan kung maglabas ng resolution ang Congress regarding abolishing sila?
Eh, kaya nga eh, nag-share din tayo eh. Ang laki-laki ng media na nagsasabi na abolish na ang private debt. Hindi kailangan talaga. All the president has to do is not release any of the funds. No problem. But what you want to do is take out that power from the president. You know, you want to say, well, this amount is going to go to that agency, to that agency, to that agency for this work. Raise their budget. And require performance from them.
So media, I give you an example. As I said, about how times last year, mas mahirap man dalawin yung special purpose fund. Pero yun ang Congress din, nag-usap sila ng DGM, ang dali-dali kasi 310 buo yan. Tapos basta minayosan lang nila ng 12 billion, dinipat doon sa Department of Health or Health Facilities. Tapos, in-announce nila, press conference, all of them were looking like heroes. So, na napapapog yan yung mga Congressman more, no? Or Health Facilities. Kasi ang paninaw namin ni Winnie, it's not as if
It's a terrible problem.
You know what it is? This is a fight for life of the corrupt politicians who wants the pork barrel is removed from them. I got to say that the pork barrel is removed from them. Wala na silang resources for the election and for dynasty. But think of it from the other point of view. Now the politicians who want to really serve the country, we have an opportunity to do so.
What happened. But if it could stop then, it can stop now.
right? Number two, it has turned out, it has been shown that those areas where wala yung port barrier, in other words, the local executive, I'm talking particularly about Cavite, with his young, handsome governor. What is it? Lemuria. No port barrier. He said, I'm sorry, no port barrier. And he said, only one out of his provincial board members did not win the election because what they offered their people was performance. And the people saw it. So politics pala, hadalang hindi na kailangan bumili ng buto. Isn't that great? It's worth it, Cindy.
Okay.
I hope I answered that question.
Can you pass the question? Because we have to... We have to wrap up. Kung gagawin na natin.
Yes, 2.68 billion mo, we go 3 billion mo, we go to where it is needed. Kasi ngayon, ay, ang accountability is only up to the level of you want. Na, yung sinasabi ko nga, hindi natin alam. Do you think you will have enough money? Yes, hindi na matatanggap. Mayroon pa, masisave from 25 billion, which will go to 77. May masisave from iba iba pa dyan, no, na mabawas-bawasan, mapupunta sa lahat. I believe so. Kalaro na tayo ng regular government employees, ang medyo naman kasi kapawin ang paying of taxes pa in advance, diba? Automatic yan, kalpas. O, yung iba naman dyan, eh, 40 billion na yung tax liabilities, eh, ano pa rin, o, ano naman sa akin, yun naman yung civilian. Pero para sa akin, kaya kami, makikita ninyo na mas malaki yung advocacy namin. Our advocacy and expression for Pusan has been since 2006. Pero hindi naman yung pinipilit. Yan na lang yung pinipilit at ilit na sa Fort Juarez. Tutuwa na kami. Kasama na kami. Kasi pagkain ko, really an opportunity for us to save ourselves. Pag we don't know na, we don't deserve all the blessings that we have given.
Professor, kasama ko nga pala sa prayer vigil doon namin ay mag-alternate ng pag-i-educate sa mga tao na nahan doon kung ano ang mga pondo nito. Ang tatanong ko sana ay makakasama po ba namin kayo sa araw na yun? Physically. Para matulungan doon ng pagpaliwan.
I would be very happy to do so kasi pero usually kasi sa province, malaki din ang pangangailangan sa provincia, no? Like yung sa March natin sa August 15, I was out at the province kasi may mga parallel din. So, para ang message natin yung buong bansa. So, I would be very happy to do that.
Kasi po ako po ang nararamdaman.
Kasi the United Church of Christ in the Philippines, the National Council of the Church. So, I would be very happy to do that. Basta maano lang sa schedule ko kasi magpatawag na yung pagamang sa provincia.
Doon ako pupunta
kasi kailangan
mag-alat tayo kung saan tayo. Maraming pong salamat. Maraming salamat. Si Dr. Malaw, may sasabihin ko at may liyanap.
Okay, so ako, wala niya ako ang estudyante, baka nito. Yung pumilatira kong estudyante, yung action paper due on Friday the 13th next week. Okay. Second